we combine the legal authority bestowed upon the two gatekeeping medical units by the state and the clinical practices of each unit, we can see a strong medicalization of gender and identity. From my position as a non-binary trans person, a queer person who went through the legal transitioning process at Kluis, that is Bambene, the medicalization of gender is violent and harmful for people on the trans spectrum who not only have their identities judged against the backdrop of pathology, but who also, should they end up failing the tests, i.e. offering a narrative the medical team considers inappropriate, might be denied life-saving treatment by the very virtue of medical power. This is a problem that affects people with queer gender identities in particular, because there is no ready-made narrative for non-binary people, nor any recommendations for the treatment of genderqueer non-binary people in Finland. You can't really discuss power without going to Foucault, who is a French philosopher who vastly discussed power and the body. And the Foucauldian body is an object, something that is subjected to a vast number of processes so as to make it useful. In 1977, he wrote, "The body is also directly involved in a political field. Power relations have an immediate hold upon it. They invest it, mark it, train it, torture it, force it to carry out tasks, to perform ceremonies, and to emit signs.